The third one is, how do I increase my SME chances of getting access to funding from banks such as the AFDB and Afreximbank Bank? The truth of the matter is that there are quite a number of opportunities, but again, it's about the function of scale. You see, most of the businesses we have, they want to solo and do it all on own. You're basically trading. You can only trade. If you do not have volume or size on your advantage, you will not be able to get it. And that's why you see that chart I showed you. The 1% or the 5% will get most of all these things because they have the requirements in there. So the requirements by this agency should be what we should focus on. If you look at the requirements, not too many SMEs will qualify for it. And that's where you find out where, I think it was Femi Boyede, one of your programs, talking about the concept of cooperatives or people working together. Again, Femi said something very interesting at the start of the show. He said something about globalization. But here's the thing, Femi, the consequences of globalization is that most advanced countries are now changing that concept from globalization to localization. Understanding and appreciating the whole value chain in playing in a global world, but understanding that they will localize most of those value of productions in those entities they are trading with rather than then ship them. It's a subject matter I can discuss further. But in terms of access to facilities, the more popular one is the Afriexim one, under what they call the Working Capital Guarantee Program. And I've seen it work for a number of companies, and they've used it to turn themselves around. Now, an interesting question is, what are the specific investment opportunities in the single market for Africa? You see, this question in itself is a consultancy opportunity. So to answer it, I felt that it was important that I explain to you all that there is always opportunities in everything, depending on what you look at. If you look at, you may not see opportunity, but if you look very carefully, you will see. But here is the thing. How many have taken time to read the different protocols of Africa? Before, after, I went through a list of agreements, and I may share with you, there are about 88 types of agreements that Nigeria has signed on to across Africa, 88 with different countries around trade. How these agreements will be harmonized together, and some will be canceled, and some will be brought together, is a major challenge. And I think that any of you here should send a proposal to government to help them sort it out. I'm not sure we have a clear idea of what it is we've all signed up into. And so we jump from one agreement to the other, not looking back at the other agreements. And so it creates it. But we see quite a number of opportunities here. And we listed some of them here, some of which I'll make available should it be requested for. But a cautionary note I picked up during my research and conversations as follows. People ask, the opportunities for investments are available, but can a Nigerian business, for example, go to Rwanda or Ghana and be treated equally or better? And with all due respect, this is one of the questions where I said our naivety sometimes underscores the fact that we haven't taken on the issue of trade and business very seriously. Nobody hands anything to anyone. There's a reason why if you have value, they will invite you to come here and say, set up your plant with us here. The whole idea is they wanted to change. But that question is powerful because it then raises the many dimensions to our approach to trade and the single market goal. For example, what is the value and place of bilateral and multilateral agreements that we sign? How do we address the limitations of tariffs and taxes? How do we deal with the challenge of non-trade barriers as countries become to be a little bit more protectionist in their approach, and for good reasons too? And what is the place of productivity and comparative advantages in an economy? Because it's in answering these four questions that matters to you why we know. For a country like Nigeria saying that I want to go to other markets, you have the largest market. Which other market are you trying to serve? It's because in your country, for example, your market is not organized. Yet, as disorganized as it is, we then begin to find the Chinese coming here and disaggregating and decoupling the market in such a way that they are able to achieve sales, or what I call the saturation of the Nigerian product and consumer market. I guess this is where the question around our trade and investment overarching policy and the absence of it becomes critical. And this is the last one will be Femi's favorite question. I think he likes talking about the mainstreaming of cooperatives within the AFTA framework. And I can see him nodding. And you are absolutely correct, 100%. There are very few efforts at mainstreaming cooperatives within the AFTA framework. This is a defect, both in conceptualization, but most importantly, it has been a problem we face in Nigeria. They are coordinating things to bring together SMEs. It's all about rhetoric, you know. The AFTA Secretariat, the Commissioner for Trade and Industry, says that the Secretariat is working at bringing SMEs together in training. If you read the Nigerian news headlines and information, you always hear things Nigeria plans to, we will do by this time. We are thinking of. You never hear, this is what we did, this is what we learned. This is, it's always what we are going to do, what we are taking off, which means there's really nothing going to happen. So to all those who are from government listening in, just consider this as being a very quiet comment on the reality, is that it is rhetoric. The unfortunate thing is that cooperatives are still seen and treated as an informal and unregistered organization, not as the clusters needed to deliver interventions to change the economy. So every time we talk about we want to grow business, there is a way to do so. You treat these cooperatives as clusters rather than individual. Those micro 441 million I showed you, they must come together as cooperatives, and that's the only way. But we treat them like outsiders in the ecosystem. But if there's any good news, it must have come from the announcement of the partnership between the National Cooperative Financing Agency of Nigeria and the Abuja Cooperative Federation, who signed a partnership with the African Diaspora Chamber of Commerce. Again, thank those of you in the diaspora to provide access to funds for cooperatives in Africa, Nigeria being one of the prime destinations. All things being equal, we hope that the funds will be used properly, but it will build up. But to support what you are doing, Femi, I think you are absolutely correct. The cooperatives is the way to go. We haven't done much in that regard. And it is my desire that we will do much. So, Madam Kemi, these are just my general thoughts. I would be happy to take questions and to explore in more detail from our esteemed participants. Thank you very much.